What's up, everybody? This is Dan Giffin. Today I'm going to show you another production tip that I use in my music. I'm going to show you really quickly how to convert audio melodies into MIDI notes really fast and how I would use that. Before we do that, I'm going to show you the track that we're working on and a little bit of shameless self-promotion. So basically what I did is I used the existing bass line right here. And that might be kind of hard to hear if you're listening on like crappy iPhone speakers. But what I did is I wanted to take the notes and strip it out of here so that I could layer this bass with another sound, which turned out to be this. And then I just basically muted and chopped up all these different clips and chose certain notes that I wanted to play as kind of a wobble effect. And so what I did is I basically just right-clicked on this and I chose Convert Melody to New MIDI Track. And when you do that, Ableton is going to bounce it down and it's going to strip out the notes, and usually it's pretty accurate. So what it does is it basically creates a new track with a really kind of crappy analog instrument sound. I wish they could have done something better, but it basically turned it into this, stripping out all the individual notes of this audio and placing those notes on this track. So let's listen back. And notice that there's a couple little bum notes in there that I don't want. So I can just click on those. If you hit fold, it makes it really easy. So if you click fold, it's only going to display all the notes that are actually captured in this MIDI clip. So then I'll just delete those, and everything else is pretty solid. If I wanted to, I could go a step further and Command A, highlight all the notes, and then I can hold down Command Shift U if you're using a Mac. PC would be Command, or would be Control instead of Command. And basically you can lock in the timing of those notes. So if I wanted to lock them in perfectly, I could choose eighth notes, how much of the timing I actually want to lock in, hit OK. And notice that they all snapped into the grid. So that's something you could do. I'm not going to do that for now. But basically what I did is now I can swap this out to any other preset I want of any other instrument. Maybe I want it to be keys or something else. Like I said, for this, I layered it with my Moog Sub 37 and then I recorded audio of that. So now you have all the notes stripped out. You can layer this bass with something else. You can have a pad on top of it following those notes, but it's just a cool way to be able to strip notes out of audio so that you can get really creative and do whatever you want with them. So give that a try. Hope that helps. If you ever need help on your own tracks, your own music, or you just want to learn new tips and tricks and have ongoing 24-hour Ableton support, then check out the link in the description. Consider joining my membership. I'd be glad to help you on your projects ongoing, and you can access more cool crap. Thanks for watching. Please click subscribe, share it with your grandma. I'll see you next time. Get down to this fucking sound.